YouTube, it's me, Bree. In today's video, I am sharing some of my favorite tips and techniques to help you become a better writer. If you're interested in becoming a better writer, you'll be happy to hear that it's, in most cases, easier than you think. In fact, you can become a better writer just by writing every day. Or if you can't write every day, by writing as often as you can, I guess. Writing is like a sport or any other activity. The more you do it, the better you'll get. Of course, in addition to just writing regularly, there are a few other things you can do if you want to become a better writer. First off, make sure you read. This is one of those cliche tips that often gets passed around in videos like this one. However, it is nonetheless the most important tip I can give you. In his book on writing, A Memoir of the Craft, famous author Stephen King says that if you don't have time to read, you don't have the time or the tools to write. One of the best ways to become a better writer is to read as much as you can get your hands on. This includes not only reading in your genre or category, but also reading widely outside your genre to get a sense of the overall market and also what other people are doing. Of course, I do recommend you also read some craft books. However, let me go ahead and emphasize that reading fiction is the best way you can get better at writing fiction. And if you're a writer, you probably already love to read, so this should be a fairly easy tip for you to implement. My next tip is to consume other art forms besides books. Now, you can also read different things such as plays and poems, but here I'm mostly talking about consuming media such as film and television and visual art and performance art and things of that nature. I don't know about you, but I have found that my creative well is best refilled by consuming other forms of art outside writing. In fact, some of my best ideas have come in the wake of seeing a play performed or watching a particularly engrossing movie. This also happens to be one of my favorite cures for writer's block. If you're feeling stuck or uninspired, try taking a walk in nature, going to a museum, watching a play, or grabbing a friend and taking them to the movies. You never know how much creativity or inspiration your trip might spark. My third biggest tip to help you become a better writer is to join a writing community. In previous videos, I've talked at length about how engaging with other people online, on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, has really helped me become a better writer. I strongly recommend you start online because you don't have to leave your house, for one. And number two, it can also just make it much more approachable. As an introvert who also has to deal with social anxiety, I personally find it easier and much less draining to engage with people online. I'm not going to spend too much more time on this because it is a topic I've covered in previous videos, but I will leave some links below to those videos and I urge you to check them out if you're interested on expanding your online platform. And hey, if you've already managed to build an online writing community, feel free to leave a comment below letting me know how much it's helped you. My next biggest tip is to watch AuthorTube videos. If this is a tip that you're interested in implementing, I have good news for you. You're already doing it. AuthorTube has helped me so much as a writer, and I have made so many friends, and I've met beta readers and critique partners, and I just cannot recommend the AuthorTube community enough for anyone who wants to learn how to become a better writer in a way that is approachable and all-encompassing. No matter what kind of writing you're interested in or what elements of the craft you want to brush up on, chances are there's an AuthorTube video out there for you. And if you're looking for channel recommendations, watch some of my previous videos where I name a couple of my favorites. The last and perhaps somewhat most intimidating tip I have to help you become a better writer is to find critique partners and beta readers and actually share your work so that they can review it. Now, I know how scary it can be to send a draft to somebody to have them basically tear it apart. Especially if it's a project you've been working on for a year or more, it can feel like someone is picking on your kid. However, as writers, we must also develop a thick skin and learn to take constructive criticism and recognize when it is being given to help improve our work rather than just to tear us down. Because trust me, in most cases, if people are taking the time to critique your work, it is because they care about you and they are interested in what you have to say, as well as the story you want to put out in the world. This can take some writers decades to understand and really comprehend. So if you start early getting critiques and learning how to take them graciously, you are way ahead of the curve. If you're not sure what a critique partner is or how they can help your writing, see my previous video all about critique partners, which I will also link to below and up above somewhere. I'm also hoping to cover in a future video how to go about finding critique partners. That's all the time I have for today. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, click that subscribe button, and ding that bell so you never miss an upload. As per usual, I'd like to give a huge, huge thank you to my Patreon supporters. Every little bit of money you send my way helps produce more content like this, as well as helps fuel my writing. If you're not currently supporting me on Patreon, consider doing so for a dollar or more a month in exchange for some exclusive rewards. And if Patreon is too big of a commitment for you, you'll now be happy to hear that I have a tip jar option, which will also be listed below. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next week. Bye!